Michael Hershman is a member of FIFA's Independent Governance Committee and a co-founder of Transparency International. He joins me now from London. Michael, does this stink to high heaven?
Well, it certainly continues to produce a cloud over the head of FIFA. FIFA can't seem to drag itself out from under the suspicion of scandal.
You're being measured in your phrases, as I might expect a man of your experience to be. But you have to admit, it's an extraordinary situation when a truncated report is published, the longer report is not, and the man responsible for the investigation says it was incomplete and erroneous.
We wouldn't be at this point if they published the entire report. I have called for the publication. Transparency International has called for the publication. Many people have. But FIFA is somewhat reluctant to let the public see what Michael Garcia's entire findings were. I might add, however, that the report, when I say to be published in its entirety, should provide for some protection for witnesses who came forward. Their name should be redacted. But nonetheless, if the report was made public, we wouldn't find ourselves in this position today of people questioning the credibility of the report.
We can go backwards and forwards, who said what and this, but the reality is FIFA won't care. And until the sponsors withdraw their money, even though Emirates already has, until the others follow suit, nothing will change. We're a business program, Michael, and the real politic is, until the money speaks, nothing will change.
Well, I think you're quite right there. Although I must say that FIFA has indeed changed. Many of the recommendations of our Independent Governance Committee were adopted by FIFA, but not all of them. We recommended term limits. That was not adopted. We recommended independent exco members. That was not adopted. So the compliance and governance process is still incomplete. And it really is up to the stakeholders, sponsors being stakeholders, should press FIFA for complete reform. Okay.
You're close to FIFA in the larger sense of the word, Michael, and I can hear viewers saying this evening, let's get down to brass tacks here, as they say where I come from. What is it that we are seeing that FIFA doesn't? When FIFA looks at this, do they see the critics as just a bunch of whingers who really don't see something that they are?
Well, FIFA believes and has believed for many years that they deserve autonomy, that they are capable of self-regulation. They have become an extremely powerful and independent organization. There is no governmental body, be it a law enforcement body or a regulatory body that oversees FIFA. It's clear now that FIFA cannot succeed at self-regulation. Right. And somehow, governments are going to have to step in, not to take away the complete autonomy from FIFA, but at least to ensure that the compliance programs and governance standards are best practices. That has to be done for the good of the sport.